Sir, I welcome the changes being proposed in the Companies Act, and the bill certainly will lead to ease of doing business in the country, a commitment that was made by this government when it was elected to office. Sir, the objective of every Companies Act is to ensure that the interest of all stakeholders is protected, be it shareholder, employees, or the government. B, ensure proper corporate governance, and C, ensure that companies are following the various laws of the land in letter and spirit. However, sir, while enacting the Companies Act, it is also important to ensure that the cost of compliance does not become prohibitive, especially in the case of SMEs, which are the backbone of our economy. Therefore, sir, while this bill seeks to amend the definition of a small company from a paid-up capital of 5 crores to 10 crores and a turnover of 20 crores to 100 crores, government should be applauded because this will help the SMEs and their cost of compliance will come down substantially. However, sir, I wish to point out that Section 203, Redwood Rule 8A, is illogical. It requires every company with a paid-up capital of more than 5 crores to employ a whole-time company secretary, irrespective of the company's turnover. Sir, there are many companies, and there are eminent chartered accountants sitting here and lawyers sitting here. There are many companies which are mere investment companies or holding companies. They do not transact any business. In a year, maybe they will have 15 or 20 transactions. But you are saying that even those companies must have a whole-time company secretary. I don't know what is the logic behind this. I moved an amendment, and I hope the Honorable Minister will look at it, although I feel that the rules can be amended and this can be corrected. Sir, I feel that the Honorable and distinguished former Finance Minister has spoken about giving loans to by the directors to the companies and loans from companies to directors. These are two distinguished, the two things which must be distinguished. One is, and these are separate things, one is giving loans to a company by a director. Small and medium enterprises actually function because they are not able to get loans from banks. So they will stop functioning if you prohibit directors from giving loans. However, when a company has to give loans to the directors, I agree that some kind of conditions must be put there. As I understand the law, today, if a loan is given by a company to a director, it is considered a deemed dividend or income in his hands. But yes, we can put some limits there so that companies' monies are not misused by directors. One last thing, sir, I would like to mention. Recently, there is a Supreme Court judgment which says that in case of a fraud in a company, the properties of an independent director or his grown-up and independent children also can be attached. So this is a very strange judgment, and I would say this is something which is causing concern to everybody, because as it is difficult to find independent directors, and this will disincentivize anybody from becoming an independent director in a company, and I would call it a case of judicial overreach. As I said, many eminent lawyers are here, and I do hope that the government will seriously take it up with the courts, because this is something which should not be permitted, because if you allow this to happen, then no independent directors would be available for companies. Thank you very much.
Dhanyavaad.